stop, and they're not going to stand down. And we saw that when the sheriff came, and when the sheriff finally broke his silence, that Cliven, you know, everyone was cheering, you know, yeah, the BLM's leaving, but he said, no, that's not it. That's not all we want. Disarm the Park Service.
Yes.
Tear down these buildings where you're forcing us to pay to go on our own land. And the sheriff was standing there shaking, and he was scared because he saw someone that wasn't just saying, all right, you're giving us a little bit, now we're going to back off.
And the sheriff never did his job.
No.
He never got rid of the BLM. He never protected the people who are being robbed by the federal government, who are being attacked by the federal government, who are having guns pointed at them. Look, folks, it's a serious thing when somebody puts a gun in your face.
Yep.
And when you've got sniper nests pointed at you, that's a very serious thing. And they had already, as Josh pointed out, they'd tasered them. They'd stuck dogs on them. They had arrested them, taken them to the ground. Dave Bundy was arrested before the guys were tasered multiple times. These guys shook off the tasers. They kept coming. And just like we're talking about the motto of the Texas Rangers, you know, when the guy in the right keeps on a coming, he's always going to take down the guy who is in the wrong. That's what we saw happening. Very meek person. Wouldn't you say that they're kind of like Ron Paul, I said earlier, but a backbone of steel. And that was true of his sons as well, of Ammon and of Dave and of Ryan. These guys were the ones that were out front, that were standing up and talking to the people. When Ammon was back there, he was keeping everybody calm. He was saying, we don't need guns. We don't need to be afraid of them. Now, there were people that were in other areas that were carrying guns. I mean, we've been at many civil rights rallies where people are standing up for their open carry rallies. And one of my sons said, I've filmed 3 rallies, and the only one where he got attacked was where people weren't carrying guns. So there is something there, not even pointing guns at him, but knowing that there are people in the crowd that do have guns. But for the most part, people were unarmed and just refusing to comply with unlawful orders. And we stared them down, and they left. And it was amazing to see these guys backing up. There's the clip of them backing up.
Yeah, I think the fact is that there were a group of people who had guns pointed at them, and they were saying, we are going to shoot you. We are going to use lethal force, and they didn't back down. It's not just a victory for this family. It's a victory for the human spirit that these people were willing to stand up and keep moving forward and not stop.
And as you can see from the report that you put together, and again, Josh was up all hours of the night trying to get this stuff together because they shut down. That's an interesting point. And they shut down the cell phone service in that area for the first several days that we were there in the protest area. And when somebody wrote a report about how it was had been shut down, and the Bundy family backed that up, said, yeah, we used to have a pretty good service out here. On Saturday, we had good coverage. We were able to live stream from the area, and that got red linked by Drudge. That was the first day that we were able to live stream from the area. For some reason, we were able to do it with Skype, but we could not get our phones to live stream up until Saturday from that area. So that changed. But it was amazing to see these guys back down. If you see that picture that we just showed up there as them walking back when they gave up, they were kind of walking backwards. They would not turn their backs on the crowd because they were afraid of the crowd. And when you see that guy with the mustache and the beard and the sunglasses come up to parley, they were afraid of Ammon. They were trying to create the terms, and the Bundys would not take their terms. They kept saying, taking the initiative, essentially. What the people always try to do is to say little things, like say, I want you to stand over here. I want you to come this way. Let's go over here to talk.
Yeah, just
they were giving the orders. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. But the Bundys were giving the orders. The Bundys were taking the initiative. And when people are showing these Homeland Security documents, and maybe they're genuine, maybe they're not, I don't know, Homeland Security may come out and say, well, this is our plan all along, and I'm sure that they are going to be back. But I'll tell you what, they were not expecting that. You know that they were not expecting it.
No.
It took them completely by surprise that we went to get the cattle.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. Yeah, and the fact that guy, I don't know who he was, BLM, whatever he was, the guy with the beard, with the glasses, he was like, we're trying to de-escalate the situation. We're trying to make you guys, you know, we're trying to make this safe. While there are guys standing behind and pointing guns at us, saying that if you come any closer, you're going to get shot. And Ammon said, you're going to leave. Those are the terms. You leave.
That's right. And I heard it bothered me so much to go back to the motel rooms. We're downloading the footage, transcoding the footage. I flipped on the news and I saw Fox News reporting this and basically saying that they stood this down because they were concerned about the safety of the public. They were the ones pointing guns at us. We weren't pointing guns at them. The people down there in the trenches were unarmed. or they had their guns shouldered, holstered like Ryan there. We're going to be right back with Josh Owens. We're going to be talking to Alex at the bottom of the hour as to what this means across the spectrum, and Jerome Corsi about China buying out America, making good on their federal debt. We'll be right back.
How can you save a ton of money and prepare for emergencies? By having your own in-home freeze dryer from Harvest Right. Now you can cut down on wasted food by freeze drying your leftovers. That's right. Create your own long-term food storage by freeze drying your own fruits, meats, vegetables, even complete meals with the Harvest Right in-home freeze dryer. Imagine the savings and the peace of mind. See how the amazing Harvest Right freeze dryer works at harvestright.com.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Great news, pure water lovers. BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com has a special discount offer for all GCN listeners. You can't do better than a Big Berkey for economy. For only 1.7 cents a gallon, a single set of filters can last for 5 to 10 years. There's none better than a Big Berkey for emergency preparedness as a backup water source. And you just can't beat a Big Berkey to remove dangerous chlorine, all types of fluoride, pathogenic bacteria, cysts, parasites, and unhealthy byproducts from municipal water. Berkey water filter systems are even powerful enough to purify stagnant pond water. For the gold standard in water filters, get a Big Berkey at BigBerkeyWaterFilters.com. And all GCN listeners get 5% off all ceramic filter systems. For details, call 1-877-99-BERKEY. That's 877-99-BERKEY. Big Berkey Water Filters, for the love of clean water.
How many good people procrastinate? When was the last time you updated your last will and testament, your living will, and your health care power of attorney? If you could get these documents included with your Legal Shield membership for no additional charge, wouldn't it just make sense to have the peace of mind of owning a Legal Shield membership? Worry less and live more with lsprotection.com. That's lsprotection.com, or call 855-340-SAVE. That's 855-340-7283.
Results will vary from case to case.
Do you want to feel awesome all day long? Do you want to sleep so good you wake up feeling awesome, the way you did when you were a kid? Feel awesome with no caffeine, just awesome tasting nutrition. Try Passion for Life and rediscover your awesomeness. Call today, 844-TRY-LIFE. Call 844-879-5433 or visit 844-TRY-LIFE.com.
Hi folks, Alex Jones here with some important information. I want to tell you about Matt Redhawk and his team of patriots over at My Patriot Supply. Several years ago, Matt was sitting in his two-bedroom apartment, frustrated with the direction this country was headed and the charlatans willing to sell us out for a quick buck. Deciding to take action, a company run by patriots for patriots was born. My Patriot Supply has never taken a loan or accepted outside funding. They now operate two distribution facilities and employ over 50 hardworking American men and women. It is rare to find companies who practice what they preach. And that's why I stock my pantry with high-quality storable foods from My Patriot Supply. Go to MyPatriotSupply.com/Alex today for special offers on emergency food storage, or call their preparedness specialist at 866-229-0927. That's 866-229-0927. Do business with someone who shares your values. MyPatriotSupply.com/Alex.
Welcome back to the Alex Jones Show. I'm David Knight, joined in studio here with Josh Owens. We just got back from the standoff in Bunkerville, Nevada, where people stood up to federal agents pointing loaded guns at us, threatening to kill us, threatening to shoot, threatening to use lethal force if we did not leave the area. They said they had a court order, Josh.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, they had a court order to use lethal force to kill everyone out there.
Right.
And I mean, the people that were on the other side of the fence, the citizens and the Bundys, they weren't standing behind shields.
That's right.
But the other guys, they had their doors open. They were standing behind shields because they're cowards.
Full body armor, helmets, and standing behind their doors, standing behind their vehicles with a loudspeaker saying, go away, go away. It was amazing because there were so many of us and we outnumbered them by so many. They truly were afraid, even though they had their shields, their body armor, their weapons pointed at us and their loudspeaker threatening us about their supposed court order. You know, they were very much afraid and it was great to see them backing up. They would not turn their backs on us as we shouted at them. We were not threatening them. They were threatening us. And yet the way they put this out from the BLM press release and the way it was reported by the mainstream media was that they were worried about the safety of the public. Yeah. They were the ones pointing guns at us. Yeah. They were the ones threatening to shoot us. We were the ones walking to them with arms up in the air, with flags in the air. It was a V for Vendetta moment, but with cowboys on horses. It was a great moment. Let me talk about this, where we go from this, because we've got Obamacare that's been put in by a lawful court order. Is it legal? Just because a Supreme Court justice says this, just because Roberts, who had already written an opinion saying that it was not legal, then for some reason, maybe it was one of the first cases of the NSA blackmailing somebody, who knows, because we see right after that, we saw things happening with Petraeus. Was it the first instance of them blackmailing somebody? Because we've got the Supreme Court Justice Roberts writing both the majority opinion and the dissenting opinion, reversing himself very dramatically. And so does that then alter the Constitution? We can read the Constitution. We know that the government does not have the right to force us to buy something. What, they don't have any rights that are not specifically given to them. That's why they went through the motions of doing a constitutional amendment to create the income tax, that tomorrow is a day that they want everybody to file the income tax. When they did that, they made it about income, and that was very different from wages. Then they extended it during World War II to wages, said they were going to do it temporarily. Then they kept that on. Now they've put on Obamacare and said they're going to use the IRS on Obamacare. How do we get out of this? Well, there's a good example back in November 15th, jury nullification. Go for your trial. Stand up for each other. That's the thing that we learned yesterday, is that if we can't count on Rand Paul or Ted Cruz to stand up there and dismantle Obamacare. We certainly can't count on the Republican leadership like Boehner. They love this kind of new power that it gives over us. They love to transfer money from the American people, property from the American people to their corporate masters. That's essentially what was going on here as well. It's the same type of things, the same patterns being put everywhere. In this particular case, you had a woman who owed no taxes, but she refused to sign the form. The IRS wanted her to fill it out using their numbers, and their numbers, of course, were zero. She said she wasn't going to do that, and so what they did was they took her to court, charged her with contempt, and this is what the judge said. This is how she instructed the jury. She said that it's not a defense to the crime of contempt that the court order was unlawful or unconstitutional. Do you hear that? It doesn't matter if what I'm telling you is unlawful and unconstitutional. You do it. And that's the attitude we saw out there with the BLM. It doesn't matter. The law is in our mouth, okay? It's a fiat law. It's a dictatorship.
Yeah, I think what was the ruling? It was Marbury versus Madison. I could be wrong about that, where it said that if it's unconstitutional, then you don't have to follow the law.
Yeah, well, you know, what we're seeing here with this is essentially we have to understand what the Constitution is. We have to understand when the laws are counterfeit or when they're just fiat, okay, when they're fiat laws. We need to know what the real law is so we can stand it down. Now, the question is, what do we do about Obamacare? In this particular case, in this lady's case, just because she would not sign the form, they take her to jail. They were trying to put her in jail, and they're instructing the jury that it doesn't matter if what I tell you is unlawful and unconstitutional. Well, you know what? There was one juror who stood up, even though he was hounded by the prosecutor's office. He stood up, nullified this. It takes one person out of 12, only 8% to stand up.
Yeah, well, what I see a lot is when we go out on the street, do these man on the streets, and people ask, well, yeah, this stuff is going on, but what are we supposed to do about it? Look at this family. Look what they did. This is what you do about it. You don't sit down. You don't take the easy way.
That's right. We're going to be right back. We're going to be joined at the bottom of the hour with Jerome Corsi, and I'm going to give you last words here, Josh, when we come back. Stay tuned. We'll be right back.
We're on the march.